Marco Lunaval with Cool State Radio. Here we are at LA's Art Walk in an exhibit where AmandA is going to tell us about her two paintings, the first one being Pandora and her inspiration behind it. Take it away, AmandA. Tell us your inspiration of Pandora.
Well, the title is actually Pandora Ambasador. So that's okay. This painting is, as well as the one next to it, the Gaia Ambassador. They're both paintings that I started as live paintings. And I began with the face in the center point, which is kind of a reflection of oneself and of maybe a shaman, of royalty, of some kind of character, a messenger, an ambassador, maybe a the Galactic Federation or something. Like, this one is definitely Pandora. This one's definitely much more space and, like, galaxy. And there's a big UFO behind it. And it has, the way I start a lot of my paintings is I kind of start from a feeling, and I'll start with the beginning. Maybe I'll start with the face. In this aspect, I started with the face, and it grew from there. So the lines and the inspiration of the people and the music and the event that's happening, I just kind of draw from that, and it just expands from there. Then it starts giving me messages that I start just building up on top of. And the painting itself that is telling me what it wants. So she's talking to me, or he, I'm not quite sure. It could be like an androgynous, it's kind of a creature from the past, a creature from the future, but it's definitely some kind of like a messenger. And to me it seems like they've got something to say, you know, and they've got some like powerful, you know.
Do you meditate?
Do I meditate?
No.
Well, you know, meditation, I kind of grew up around a lot of meditation, a lot of metaphysical stuff, and to me meditation is in everything I do, if I do it consciously. So painting is kind of like a meditation for me.
I've heard that when you silence the mind, inspiration, so you plug into the divine cosmic, and that's where you get your inspiration. It's there, just waiting to be discovered.
Yeah, most definitely. One tool that I've used a lot, actually, lately, and discovered more and more that it helps me a lot, is to have some kind of distraction of my intellect by listening to something educational, like a radio show or a book, or even talking on the phone to somebody sometimes, distracting my mind and painting at the same time. Like I'm separating those two and allowing something else to come through. And the goal is for me to kind of like listen more to the painting and become more open, that whatever can come through me has an easier way. It doesn't get mixed up in my ego.
I have a little, I need a little more explanation. Tell me more.
What's the purpose? Well, I do believe that there is a greater power and a greater maybe puzzle maker. You know, there's something going on.
Yeah, divine.
There's some kind of evolution happening. And it has to do with consciousness. It has to do with us figuring out how we can live on this planet in a harmonious
sure he does. Well, go ahead and put it on YouTube as on the tags.
Yeah.
So then when he looks for himself, he'll find you.
Yeah. Well, I know I'll get him one of these days.
Well, I'll send you the copy and we'll work on that together. That'll be our next project. But right now, take us away to the other ambassador.
Okay.
Cut.